during the course of practice in medicine, I've come across people with rare diseases that are perhaps a little too complex or a little bit obscure for other people to be involved with. And I've always thought, well, perhaps I could do something. And with an interest in biochemistry and pathology, I've sort of taken on rare conditions like Krabbe disease. And we've had a long-standing scientific interest in Krabbe disease for the better part of 12, 13, maybe 15 years, I've lost count. Good doctors and good scientists hunt in packs, so I like to work with a team of people, and so I work with my clinical colleagues and colleagues here in the laboratories who have an interest in these particular diseases and to put them right. Krabbe disease is one of the most significant genetic diseases that affects children because of its extreme severity.
Most common form is the infantile form, and that's extremely severe and very acute, and the children die by about 2 years of age. It's a neurodegenerative disease. It affects both the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. It's a demyelinating disease, and the children become very irritable and very unwell very quickly.
Fortunately, very few people get Krabbe disease. It is extremely rare. There are perhaps 10 or 20 cases a year in the UK. The rarity of the disease is no comfort for those that suffer from it. There is certainly no cure. There's no definitive treatment whatsoever, really, at the moment. Sparks has very recently granted to us 2 years laboratory support for a very novel and exciting project related to a recent discovery that a new inflammatory process seems to be occurring in the brains of children with a related disease, Gaucher disease. It's called necroptosis. We intend to show whether or not this process is activated in Krabbe disease with support from two major companies for evidence that this inflammatory process is occurring. And the reason for doing that is that these companies are developing medications, drugs, new drugs, that can interdict, stop that process going on. We have great hopes for getting a definitive answer for, and if that answer was a positive one, could really have great consequences.